Thank you everybody for coming out. Happy New Year. It's good to see everybody.
This is Tyrone Williams, the community liaison for the Sherbet Mission Act, and he's also a member of the community outreach person for the Sherbet Mission CDC. So on behalf of Sherbet Mission Neighborhood, we welcome you to our monthly forum. So we were fortunate enough to have a good partnership this year with the new principal. He allows us to use this space once a month so we can just come together as a community and talk, whether it's about current issues that are going on, current issues that are pending, so forth and so on. So this is our like third or fourth one. How many have been to all of them? We've been together like, go ahead, yeah, I'm looking at Louis Diane, but she better raise her hand. So yeah, so the idea is to make sure that we have a way that we can communicate on a regular basis. Some of us are good at email, some of us are good at just flyers, some of us are good at just talking word of mouth. So this is a way that we can all come together and address some of the issues in the community.
I'm trying to give you an update of what we're doing with the Strawberry Mansion funds and the Strawberry Mansion High School in general, of how we're diverting our funds. The biggest thing we need is community partners. Okay, we're starving for community partners, okay? So I opened up my door, the door to the school, my house is your house. So, whatever time you want to do something in the community, this is a good place to do it, okay? So, just keep that in mind. We need partners. Our kids need you, okay? I'm one guy. I got two assistant principals. I got 27 teachers, a bunch of staff. We still need you. So, I need you to help out. Come to these meetings. Come visit the school. I'll give you a tour. Let you know the good things we're doing. So, we get past the first page of Facebook and YouTube, and get to the second and third page of Facebook and YouTube.
Yes.
But we're doing something good.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
Next slide. So how are we doing this year compared to how we have done in the previous year? This is a myth. Everybody's saying we're doing bad. Next slide. We are not doing that bad. Go ahead, next slide. We're gonna look at benchmarks, go ahead. Keystones, attendance, and suspension. Go ahead. Next slide. All right. So this is what we were at. 2015, 2016. These are the benchmarks. This is where we're at now. Is that a lot? No. Is it big significant?
Yes.
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 It's big. But this doesn't get printed out in anywhere. This is just my data that I get. The district sees other data metrics. This is one that we need to see. Next slide. Again, this is the English one, this is the algebra one. See how we were here? 7.9, we dropped to 7.5. That's a 0.5 drop. Most schools are dropping points, 3-4 points. Will it drop? I have a point.
Can you find the
number? Oh, 7.9% of people pass a getting a proficient. So they get proficient, that means that they met the requirement for the state. This is the bio one, as you can see, it went up in 2016, 2017, then it started going back down. Now, a lot of this usually happens during the transition, okay? There's a transition, for example, you get a group of 9th graders or 10th graders that they're above average, right? And so you ride that. So this is the above average freshman, right? Sophomore, junior. When they get here, they graduate, and the one that was behind them, maybe they didn't get the biology they got from before they came to Strawberry Mansion. Maybe they were transferees. Maybe they were repeaters. And then we start seeing a decline. My focus is from here to here to get the kids that are doing well going up, keep them going up, and stop these guys from dropping.
Yes.
Biology is our worst subject. They don't just do well in biology. But we have a new teacher, we have new direction, and we just scored one of the highest benchmark scores of all the turnaround schools for the last benchmark. English one, same thing, you see the increase, and then the decrease again. Next slide. Okay, so algebra one, as you can see, we We dropped 2 points in the performance for these down again, 2016, 2017. What I don't have is the latest, this is last year's data. I don't have the latest benchmark, and that went up again. So right now from this benchmark, just like the biology one I told you about, we went up again. We have a new English teacher, very energetic. She's getting a lot of coaching from us, and she's seeing improvement already. One of the problems we have in Strawberry Mansion is retention. We can't keep our teachers more than a year. The district allows them to transfer in 1 year. Because it's a turnaround school. Any other school that's not turnaround, they gotta stay for 2 years. Here, after 1 year, they can leave and I can't stop.
Wow.
Now I can make them comfortable, but to me, comfortable is you still need to work.
Yes.
So a lot of them, my reputation precedes me. They know I'm gonna be stickler for instruction. A lot of them left when I got the job. That's okay. I got new replacements and we're doing great. But the ones that left, you don't wanna work.
See you later, man.
Amen.
That's right.
So these are Keystone's learning proficiency scores. You can see the same triangle. You can see it. It went up and it's going back down. We didn't lose much. So we gotta stop this meeting right here. This is what we gotta stop. And that's what we're focusing on. So these are the different years. The goal is here. You can see how we started. We're up here. But you can see that this is lower, this is better. 2018, we have improved. From this year, no one's been up that high. So we have definitely improved. Okay, this is our attendance. So we have a notoriously low attendance at Strawberry Mansion, okay? And we have tried everything. We have town hall meetings, we have incentives, we have tried a little party with them, pizza parties. They just, sometimes they come, sometimes they don't. And we understand that our community is healing, and we're doing every effort to get them in here. That's what we need for help. So you can see that for 2018 here, last year we had a little better attendance, but you can see how this dipped, and this is more of a slow decline. So it has been improving, but not as much as I would want. But we still, our attendance is getting better. We got 302 kids in this building, and we suffer from 50 to 60% attendance rate. So half of our kids aren't here all the time. So we gotta go out there and get them, and which we do. Next one. Okay, so you can see we have attendance issues. Okay, we have teacher retention issues, and we are addressing these every day. Another problem we're having is teacher attendance when they're here.
Yeah.
So teachers assigned here, then they take off a day or two. The problem is we have a block schedule. So you see your teacher Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So you miss a Monday and a Wednesday, you don't miss 2 weeks worth of work. Mm. That's the problem, you see? But they're there for 100 minutes. So one class is really two. So they miss 2 days. You see where we're going with this? So now, and here's another problem, which I'm gonna fix next year. Most of my core classes are in the morning, which I'm gonna change next year. Now, hindsight, I'm gonna put my core classes in the afternoon. Because by the time they get in the building, they don't miss English or algebra. I can't fix it if you're not here.
Okay? Right.
Next one. Okay, so keep going. In the class, missing the class. In other words, they took English last year and they failed. We cannot go back and keep giving them English again. We gotta give them the next level English. So they gotta sign up for credit recovery. Mm-hmm. Twice a week. It's called Ingenuity, okay? Here's the good thing about Ingenuity. Once they come in that one time, and they wanna come in here and be safe, and do the work, twice a week, 3:15 to 4:15, a teacher's ready, we got you. You don't wanna do it here, I'll give you access to do it at home. This is an online program. You log in, you do the work, we get the record here. Now, here's the problem. The minimum is 100 hours for a course, between 100 and 180 hours. I can't cut that down. I try a lot, but they don't let me cut it. So the kid has put a lot of time into this, which is a full credit course. So it's available. Our attendance for credit recovery is low. Please, spread the word. You have a junior who wants to be a senior and graduate, they do this course, 2 classes, they can go from a junior to graduation and be out of here. But they're not spending the time. If you got a freshman who's repeating, freshman's available too, do it after school, do it at home. get that credit so I can move you up to a true sophomore. We shouldn't have this problem in 2 years from now. It's available. So that's credit recovery. Grade recovery. You take a class right now, you fail it. You get a 50. See the report card comes up? They go, oh my God, I got a 50. Don't get discouraged. I got a plan for you. The plan is I will give you a very, very comprehensive packet. It went out today. That packet goes out today. 2 weeks from now, 3 weeks from now, you turn it in, I grade it. I take your 50, it becomes a 65. You're not failing the class anymore. The plan, the paperwork that I give you is based on the stuff that you missed. I'm just not giving you a package. I'm creating a package based on that credit recovery program. Mm-hmm. So if I need to prove that you got a 65, I got the document to prove. Okay, and I'm the only one that can change the grade. So unless they go through me, I'm not changing anything until I've got the document. So the kids, I've been fighting me a little bit on that.
Challenging. I don't say hard because the only thing hard is the concrete that we walk on. Everything else is a challenge. I'm ready for this challenge, and I was built for this. I think that we all have a purpose in life, and mine's to take on a task that most will back away from. That impossible, so people say.